Even now, I can smell your clothes freshly from
the morning, babe. I'm sitting here and it's 2:30 now. I've been up since, I think, 1 or 1:15, something like that. Anyhow, I'm feeling better. I feel like I don't feel 100%, but I feel better than I did yesterday. And I don't feel quite so lightheaded. Like, I don't feel very lightheaded at all right now. Anyway, I'm hoping maybe today will be a better day. Maybe I can actually get out and get the tires done now that I've purchased them and they're sitting at the tire place. But we'll see. I do not think that I will do the water Zumba today. I don't think that's a smart choice yet. I think maybe I'll wait, and they have another class on Friday, so I think I'll try to hold off and go on Friday, and maybe I'll be doing a little bit better by then. Or at least feel better long enough that I feel comfortable to go. What else? I never did get the sheets washed yesterday, so maybe if I'm feeling up to it, I can get that done today. I did get some laundry done, but not. It's in the washing machine. Oh. Yeah, it was a rough afternoon yesterday, but so far I feel better this morning, so we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Didn't really talk to you very much yesterday. Hopefully today we'll have a little bit better communication. Other than that, I have no plans today. Everything's going to just fall on how I feel, and then depend on how I feel. So anyhow, this is your entry to day 52. But sometimes it feels like these days, maybe it's because I video them and I acknowledge what every single day is. But yesterday was kind of a slow day, but most of the days feel like they've gone by pretty quickly. I sure hope your days are going by as quickly as mine are, because it would really suck if they were like in slow motion for you. I love you. Anyways, I'm going to get off of here, and I know it's early in the morning. I said I'm not going to eat early in the morning, but man, I am hungry. So maybe just something little. Anyway, I'll talk to you in a little while. I love you, baby, and I miss you. I wish you were home. I don't even know where to start this, so never once up until this moment have I wished that we could just go back to the days of letters. I guess this has been coming for a couple weeks now, in this, the communication that I have with you. I would rather not hear from you at all, I think, and get a letter, or at least have one conversation. I'd rather not hear from you for days, and then be able to actually have a conversation with you, rather than this, you send me one line saying something, I respond, and I get nothing back from you. I respond again, I get nothing back from you. And then a little while later, you'll come back and you'll say something, and then I'm like, have to be glued to my phone to see if you're going to say something. And then half whatever you say doesn't even really make sense from what you were saying before. And then I'll respond to that, whatever the new thing is that you've written. I'll respond to it. You don't respond back. And then a little while later, I'll get something that says, okay, well, babe, I hope you have a good day. I'm getting ready to go eat and go and watch. I'm over it. I can't even. I need a break from this. I can't take it. It is so stressful. Like, it's so stressful. I'm not going to be glued to this phone anymore. I'm not doing it. I can't. It's literally going to send me off the deep end. You know, I haven't said anything on these videos, but you know how I feel about this. I just can't. I understand if you're busy, you're busy. But just don't try to include me in your busy then. Because sending me something that requires a response, or, you know, insinuates that you want a response, and then I respond and I get nothing. You know, and then I don't know. Can I get in the shower? Do I get in the shower? Do I wait? Because if he does respond, he's going to expect something back from me. I don't even know how I feel right now. I'm incredibly frustrated. We'll see if I cut this clip out or if I leave it in here. I don't know. And maybe all the other wives feel the same way. Maybe they don't. Maybe they're more understanding than I am. Maybe I've had enough of this shit for 24 years that I'm just fed up with the way that things go. I don't know. Maybe I'm just frustrated and having a moment. Maybe that's all it is. Maybe I just need a drink at 7:45 in the morning to manage this. I'm so frustrated right now. And then after everything that I said to you, everything about how I'm trying to explain to you how I feel, the response is, I'm sorry you're so frustrated. I just want to say good morning before I go on watch. That's it. That's the response. It's like, regardless if you agree with me or not, it's almost like saying that how I feel isn't even valid. Yeah, I'm really frustrated this morning. We'll see if I leave this clip in here or not. Maybe I'll have time to mull this over when I'm not so frustrated and I'll think about it differently and I'll see it from a different perspective. I don't know. But for now, I'm incredibly, incredibly stressed out and frustrated with this communication. And I'm just not sure what's at fault. All right, I love you. I'll get on here later. Hey, babe. So I am going now to go get your tires done. I don't think I'll do a whole lot today. I put our sheets in the wash. And a load of laundry in with them because I have room. And I'm going to get the tires done. And I don't know what else I'll do today. It depends on how I'm feeling. My chest still hurts. I don't know. I'm not dizzy, so that's good. Yesterday was incredibly dizzy and I just couldn't function very well. But today, the dizziness has all but disappeared, except when I go to stand up from sitting. But that doesn't seem too abnormal. Maybe just a little more than I would normally have it. But otherwise, it's a lot better today. So I'm going to try to get a few things done that I need to do. And hopefully, I won't have a repeat of yesterday. At least I know I'm not having a heart attack. Because they did an EKG and said that my heart was fine and my lungs sounded good. I don't know what the heck happened. But anyhow, alright, well, I'm gonna get off of here, but that's where I'm going. And oh shoot, I just forgot you. Do I turn around and go back? I've gotta be there in like 15. No, I can't. Man, I just literally walked out and left you sitting in the bedroom. Dadgummit. It was the last thing I was going to grab. I had my hands full and I tried to go to the bathroom one last time because you know me. I got to go to the bathroom 3 times before I can get out of the house. Dadgummit. Oh well. What are you going to do? All right. Well, you won't make it on my errands with me today. And I was going to go to Big Lots too while I was out if I was still feeling it because there's a couple things I wanted to get. Okay. Well, so much for that. I love you. And I miss you, and I will talk to you in a little while. All right, babe. Well, I just got your tires done, and I'm heading to Big Lots without you, of course. Those people, I tell you what, they were really pushing that. They wanted me to buy all 6 tires. I'm like, no, those tires in the back have plenty of tread on them. They are not bald by any stretch of the imagination. And I'll get them. I'll get to them when I get to them. But I ain't doing them. I'll do them in my time, not somebody else's time. I mean, I get it that they're trying to push their tires, but come on now. And I told you yesterday I wasn't going to buy any more tires. I'll get the 2 tires, and that's the extent of it. Unbelievable. Anyway,
Discount Tire is actually literally around the corner from Big Lots, so I just went from one red light to the next red light, and I'll be at Big Lots. I'm just getting a couple things in there, nothing crazy. And then, I don't know, I think I might actually just head home for the day and try to get some cleaning done. I don't know, I thought about taking myself out to lunch, but you're not supposed to be taking yourself out to lunch, Danny. You're supposed to be eating, like, healthy stuff. But anyhow, so that's the scoop, and I'm done with the tires. I got it done. I still feel okay. Got in and out of the truck without feeling dizzy and getting it done. Slowly but surely, feeling a little bit better, a little bit at a time. All right, well, I just got to Big Lots, so I'm going to hang this up, go inside, go do what I got to do, go see what else Big Lots has for me, because you know I love me some Big Lots. I don't know why I had to park like this. Dana, come on, you know better. Car right here is going to be not real happy with me, but oh well, they'll get over it. I'll pull the mirrors in. Alright, well, I'll talk back to you in a little bit, but your tires are done. I only bought two. They did not browbeat me into buying any more. So, alright, I love you, babe. Hey, babe. So, I've now been sitting in the Big Lots parking lot for about half an hour talking to you. After all that ranting this morning, we were finally able to figure out a schedule, and I think that's the best thing. Not only did I rant on the video about how crazy it was, I messaged you about how crazy I was feeling about this communication thing. I think we've come up with a good solution. I think that it's fantastic, and you know, maybe sometimes instead of getting so frustrated, we just need to talk about it real quick and come up with, like this, a solution. So I know when you're going to be messaging me, approximately, and when you're going to be expecting responses from me, and then I know when you'll just be shooting me a message to say I love you and I miss you, and there's no response needed. I think that that's a great compromise, and I think that we did a good job coming up with that. I'm very proud of us. Ah, I'm proud of me. I'm not so mad anymore. I was really frustrated this morning. I was really, really frustrated, but, you know, you always talk me through it. You always do, and we worked it out. Now we have a system. We'll see how it works. Anyway, it was amazing to hear from you. It was great to bounce a few things off of you and to hear what you thought about it and to talk to you about what happened yesterday and what's just going on in life in general, so that was really nice, and the Facebook messages come in a lot faster on Messenger. They come in a lot faster than on the text message, so that helped tremendously. And the fact that I knew that you weren't going to be done texting me immediately, and so I was able just to sit here and not start driving and then start getting bombarded with messages that I couldn't respond to because I'm behind the wheel. So, you know, I'm never going to be that person that texts and drives. I'm just not going to do it. I can try the talk to text, and I don't mind to do that. But sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't work. And I don't want to sit here, you know, fiddling with it when I need to be focusing on the road, because that's just how I feel about it. Anyhow, I love you and it was really great to talk to you. Changed my whole mood for the day. Thank you. I needed that. Anyway, I will talk to you later on. I hope you're getting a good night's sleep now because I know you're going to bed. And I will talk to you around this time again tomorrow. All right. I hope you have a good day. I'm not done videoing. I'm sure I'll put a closing video to this later, but it is already past 8 minutes long, so I probably won't video the rest of the day. I'll just wait till this evening and say goodnight to you. All right. I love you, babe. Thanks so much for taking the time to, you know, make these messages count today. I appreciate it more than you'll ever know. All right. I love you, baby.
Hey, baby.
So it happened to work out that Frankie just called me and she has time to do my hair. So I think I'm going to go ahead and, well, actually I know I am because I'm already in the car. I'm going to go up there and have her give my hair a trim because I need it badly. And I went to Rigoletto's and had pasta vasool and I had a half of a antipasto salad. And I am stuffed. I am way full, and I'm gonna go do this. I just got home, and I was planning on doing some things, but when she messaged me, you gotta go when your girl messages. So, anyway, I'm going to do that right now, get myself trimmed, got my meds picked up, got a bill paid, and pretty much it. The laundry's still in the washing machine and the dryer. So I'm hoping I got, my sheets are in the washing machine, so those gotta be dried before I can go to bed tonight. But this won't take too long. She'll do my hair and hopefully blow dry it out for me too. Pay for the extra. I love when anybody else will blow dry it besides me, since it takes so long to blow dry this curly crazy mess. But anyway, so I just want to let you know that's what I'm doing. Frankie's gonna give me my haircut. All right, I love you. Miss you. Hey, baby. I am currently sitting in the parking lot waiting on Frankie to get off work. We're having our wacky Wednesday going to the movies. Although I wish it was a lot earlier than this because this girl is tired. I have a hard time staying up this late, so we'll see how I do. But the movies are about 20 minutes from here. I think we're going to leave the truck at Walmart and then just take her car to go to the movies. Yeah. So, this is probably going to be my good night video for tonight, because I don't know that I'll have it in me when we get home to do it. But it was a pretty good day. I got everything done that I needed to. I didn't have near the problems today that I had yesterday, and communication with you today was wonderful once we came to consensus on how we needed to do this, so we weren't hit and miss as much as we were, and it made it a lot better for me. For sure. Hopefully it did for you too. And I wasn't aggravated anymore. So that's it. It was a good day. I got everything done that I was supposed to. Got the laundry done. The bed is made. And sheets are washed and the bed is made. And I did not do the kitchen floors like I said I was going to. I just didn't get around to that. I wasn't really home to do it. I ran up here to have Frankie do my hair and stuff. And so, But yeah, otherwise it was a productive day, I think. I did things I was supposed to do, and I'm all done, and now I'm going to go have my Wacky Wednesday with Frankie. Wacky Wednesday is where the movies are at the Cinema Cafe, and they are $4 a ticket, so it's the way to go. So anyhow, well, I love you, and I miss you, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Good night, babe.